Hey everyone, welcome back to Goat's Beach Place, home of the Gila monster. Today we're going to talk about ultrasound and Gila monsters. Ultrasound and Gila monsters is important because it's currently the safest and most accurate way of telling sex in adult Gila monsters, as well as it gives us an insight into the reproductive going-ons as we head into breeding season. So we can learn a lot as we look into our Gila monsters with our ultrasounding. I want to say thank you to everyone who watched the first video. I hope you really enjoyed it, and I hope you enjoyed this one too. So let's go ahead and get started. As we begin ultrasounding Gila monsters, we have to go over some of the basics. Obviously, you need an ultrasound machine like we have back here. You really need one with a linear probe like you see here. That's one with a flat, smooth surface. And last but not least, certainly not least, is an adult Gila monster. So Mr. Winston, our known male and our good friend, will be the first to go, and we'll go through all of our Gilas here and see how they're doing. And we'll do it several times through the season to keep track of them reproductively up until about the time they lay egg. Let's check out and see what's going on.
So here's a basic picture of the things you will need to ultrasound a Gila monster or any reptile. You need the ultrasound unit. Need the unit with a probe, preferably a linear probe. Ultrasounding gel. I also have mine that works with USB, as well as has a keyboard to it, so it makes it a lot easier if I have to input data.
Before we get started, I do want to say that I am not a veterinarian and I'm not a vet tech. I've never had one formal day of ultrasound training, and I'm only sharing what I've learned here with my Gila monsters with the machines I've used. I'm actually on my fourth machine that I've bought either through eBay or Craigslist or Facebook Marketplace, and I finally found a machine that I think works great for the program. So you'll probably go through a couple machines, or maybe you'll find the machine that you like, but the settings and everything you do is all different based on the machines and your training and how you interpret the results. I must say, if you don't feel comfortable doing ultrasounds, Gila monsters, or working with them in that capacity, I strongly suggest you go to your vet because they know how to interpret the results right the first time as they're trained to do it. So I'm only here to share with what I've learned, so enjoy.
Here's our basic ultrasound screen. Go real quickly here to give you a basic idea as to what you're doing. Your ultrasound will more than likely be different unless you have the same exact unit that I do. A lot of the settings are similar in that as you change them, you'll see how they affect the screen and everything. You're gonna see here, I'm just kind of going through so you can see how the screen changes as the presets for this particular ultrasound look a little different. So here's my first batch of scans, Gila 1. And then there's Gila 2. The big difference is you hear the screen size, right? So this is a much more zoomed in area. Well, the reason for that is if you go over here to depth, it determines how far into your scan area you want to go. So generally, you know, between 4 and 7 for Gilas is about where I want to be. So you go to 4, go to 3, it really zooms in. But, you know, the problem is if you zoom in too much and you miss your area of interest, which is, let's say somewhere in here, you see your follicles. You don't want to scan beyond that, but also you don't want to scan too far out. So if we go out to, let's say 7 meters, I think this goes out to 9 centimeters. So your follicles would be up here, so you wouldn't see them nearly as well. So you want to play with your depth as you're going through it. I've had several ultrasounds, and all of them have to freeze the screen in order to measure. Between two lines. It tells you right here at the bottom what the size of that is. You can do two different measurements. And then you can record 1, 2. Most ultrasounds, most modern ultrasounds do have that for measuring. So that shouldn't be an issue for you. If you do that, let's go ahead and unpause the image. There are a lot of different other things you can do. One of the biggest ones is gains, the near gain, the far gain, and that's what all this stuff does. Overall gain. So if you've got an image that's too dark or too light, or you want to pronounce something, like you want to see something better, you can change it to where you kind of pops out at you. And that's what I do. Whenever I see it, I see it best. That's like, okay, that's where I want to be. Another important function is you can actually change, call it patient. Obviously, not a human patient, but these are little Gila monsters. So we put their names in here, their IDs, and it calculates a date and saves a file for us that way. Obviously, like us here, if you're doing a bunch of Gila monsters, you want to have your Gila monsters named, and you want to know who you're scanning. So you're pulling it up later on in the future, you can identify who you did it by. Gain. You got power. That's the power of your transducer, which we'll go over in just a second here. Contrast. Change the contrast settings. Now this is different depths. You can change your gain at different depths. So me, I have it more towards the outer depths because that's really what we're looking for here for Gila monsters. We're doing the eggs and the follicles a little further out, and we can change some basic stuff. So your ultrasound will definitely be a little different than this, but it'll have very similar settings, if not the same settings at some point. Now here we're going to talk a little bit about the transducer or the probe. This is obviously what takes the actual image. You know, you put it up against something, you roll back and forth, or in the case of Gila monsters, rub against the belly, and it kind of shows you what you're doing there. But that's how it makes contact with the skin. As we go through it, you'll hear me refer to this as the probe or the transducer. It's the same thing. Obviously, you want to keep this looking nice. Mine has nice controls on it, so I can do some controls one-handed, freeze it, as well as do measurements, all from this little probe here, which is a very nice thing to have. And that's the basics of the actual ultrasound unit. Let's go ahead and get back into ultrasounding our Gila monsters. As promised, we're gonna go ahead and start our ultrasound adventure with Mr. Winston here. We know he's a male Gila monster. He's bred several times. He has definitely been ultrasounded several times too. He's one of my guinea pigs. Hey buddy, how you doing? We're gonna get checked out. Before we get started, there are a couple different ways of doing ultrasound. You can put him in a warm bath. I don't do that, not because it's better or worse, it's just not what I do. I do use ultrasound gel here. Now, do not want to condone this as a way to handle Gila monsters. This is how I handle them in ultrasounding. I usually do my ultrasounds by myself. I put the ultrasound right on his beautiful little belly. Now I have my settings already here. The nice thing about this ultrasound is that you can control it right from the probe here. And as you see, oh, there's a testy right there. A little testy. Now we can go ahead and measure it because they do get bigger and smaller throughout the season. One side to the other side, we're about 12 and a half millimeters. And we're gonna save that image. That was quick and easy.
So here we go with part two. Second day trying to ultrasound the female Gilas. Yesterday they didn't want to be ultrasounded. They're a little spicy and flopping around. So we're gonna try them again today and see how they're doing. And there is a beautiful reticulated Gila monster, as we can see. And of course she's a little spicy. Okay, a lot spicy. All right, mama. Make this fast and quick. All right, so ultrasound is set up with my presets that I use for my ultrasound on my Gilas. And you can see she's kind of definitely wants to get a piece of me here, so again, using caution is required. We're going to give us one more shot today. See how she does. All right, and here we go. Again, there are different techniques to use. Look at that. You can see all those follicles. Hang on. There we go. Right away, we can see nice round follicles right here. Get our measurement, 14 and a half millimeters. As you see, we're going to start right around the mid body here, and there we go. Look at all those follicles. There we go. Yeah, all those round things are growing follicles, as you see throughout the screen here. All right, I'm gonna do a little video here for you guys. Moving the transducer around to a couple of different areas. She's being pretty good overall. She doesn't want to be here doing this, so I can't necessarily blame her. Fun to have this jammed in your abdomen, I would reckon. You can even come in from the side shot a little bit. You can still see the follicles on the side too if you're having a tough time getting it on the belly. Yeah, there we go. Now we're going to do Gila number 24. This is Lucy, a beautiful, beautiful band of Gila with a nice pattern on her. One thing I forgot to mention is you should always have lots of paper towels nearby when you're ultrasounding, because this stuff is definitely a mess. So we'll see if we can get Miss Lucy here, see what's going on inside of her. They're a little warmed up and activated. I apply directly to the Gila. I know there's different ways of doing it, and I'm sure there's a vet tech somewhere probably cursing my name for doing it like this, but this is how I do it, and this is the way it works for me. But let's see how this goes. Rub it all over the skin. Okay. There we go, some follicles. Hang on, mama. There we go. Kind of more at the top there. There we go, some follicles right there. Right here. We have those follicles that are showing up on the ultrasound here. Start a little video too. Oh, there we go. There's some follicles right there. Nice pre-vitellogenic follicles. Come on, mama. So if you look where I'm ultrasounding, it's right in the middle of the Gila. Now, she would absolutely bite me in a heartbeat if I let go of her, so I'm trying not to let that happen. There we go. Nice follicles. I don't think they're as big as the other ones. I haven't bred this Gila before, and this is her first time with us. Oh, there we go. There's some pretty big ones up there. Come on, mama. It's all right. Come on, mama. We're almost done. There we go. Yeah, they all seem about the same.
Well, that's about going to wrap it up here at Goatsby's Place for our ultrasound video. This is the first. We're going to keep ultrasounding our Gila monsters throughout the breeding season, and we'll be certain to bring you guys along with us, and we'll do some more ultrasounds. We'll see how the follicles mature, and they eventually become eggs, and then we'll track them even after that, after they lay eggs. We'll track them and see how they're doing. So this is just the beginning, kind of get a baseline as to where we're starting from, and we'll track it from here and go from there. But thanks for watching. We appreciate coming by the Goatsby's Place, and we'll see you next time.